from picturesque Penn Park in University City. It's college softball on ESPN Plus. Today, two Philly foes square off as the Hawks of St. Joseph's travel to face off with the Penn Quakers. And with that, we thank you for tuning in this afternoon. Gary Ridley with you from Philadelphia.
Lead, Ellie Bailey, first pitch. Belted out to right field. Going back, and you can forget it. Bailey, deep to right field. See ya. A two-run homer as Bailey throws up the deuces. 11-1. Red Raiders on top. First baseman for the Terrapins. First pitch from Fritz. Swung on, drilled high and deep to right field. God, see ya! A solo homer gets Maryland on the board in the bottom of the seventh.
It was Texan versus Texan on that one.
Three homers, seven RBIs on the year. She comes in, bases loaded. Down by three, top five, first pitch. Fastball down, it's 0-1. Today struggled 0-2. Batting at 300, 486 slugging. Go ahead, run at the plate, 0-1. Swung on the ground, over to third, the step on the bag, throw to first, and it's in time! Madison Bowerly, a 5-3 double play, gets the Quakers out in quite a jam. Bottom of the fifth we go, Penn up by three, 4-1. Come back in a moment on ESPN+. Nobody down, the runner at first, set by deliver, swung on and drilled deep to left field, and that one is gone. Deuces. Another two-run homer for the Red Raiders. As Ellie Bailey will step emphatically on home plate and walk things off in five. 9-1, your final for Texas Tech.
If you're getting, you know, one or two scattered per inning and keeping them off the base paths.
This one's cracked into deep center field, going back to the track, to the wall, gone! Another two-run homer for the Red Raiders. Their first of the day makes it 4-0, Texas Tech. Alana Barraza, deep, dead center field. 4-0, Red Raiders.
In five Ivy League games, 35 strikeouts in that time for Lonslager, the 1-2. Swung on, missed, strike three. Adds another one. A 10 strikeout performance in the opener of the series. She sits down Sarah Schneider. Start off the bottom of the second. One away. Lonslager records a punch out. 14 appearances a year ago for Riley, posting a 4.91 ERA. She comes in here working with the bases loaded against her. Full count, one out pitch. Papert awaits. Sit and deal, Riley, pitch, called, strike three. Huge, huge strikeout from Rachel Riley on 3-2, deals a pitch on the outside and records out number two. Bases loaded against her as Sophia Marcello will step in and lash hope for Princeton. Bases loaded. Go ahead, run at the plate. First pitch from Riley is swung on, popped up, and the grab is made! Sammy Fenton at short hauls things in, and the Quakers pull off the upset in game two, 6-3 final from Philadelphia.
2-1. As this one driven out to left center field, going back and gone. See ya! A two-run shot extends the lead for the Red Raiders. With two outs on the board, Texas Tech.
As we mentioned, first pitch from Bean is popped up into foul ground, going after his Barrel Lane, diving, sprawling, and she got it! Sammy Fenton
comes over from short and makes the grab, ends the inning, retires the side as we go bottom of the first. What a play from Sammy Fenton.
Hit by pitch, 2-0 pitch. Popped up in the center field, going back, deep, back, and gone. See ya. Second homer of the inning, and it's another two-run shot. And Alana Barraza's fourth of the year extends the lead to 3. Schneider 1-for-2 on the day. Base hit in her last at-bat. Eventually came around to score alongside Jaden Montgomery. 2-2 runner at first, two away. Two is flying in for Schneider. As Harrington gets a sign, sets in, deals, pitch, swung on, lifted in the left field. Schneider will take it for a ride, deep back, gone, see ya! Sarah Schneider, a two-run homer, extends the lead for Penn, 6-1. Quakers on top. Third homer of the year for the senior. As Schneider deep to left field, and the Quakers up by 5. Two-two. Inside, called. Strike 3, and Bean got her. Peyton Bean able to record strikeout number 3 on the day. Send us to the bottom of the 5th. Tied at 1 apiece from Philadelphia. Come back in a moment on ESPN+. As she'll try and start a bottom of the 6th inning that the Quakers would like to add some more runs. They only lead by 2 after holding a 3-0 advantage going into the top half of the 5th. Columbia was able to get 2 across. And then Penn was able to answer with 1. This one popped up center field, deep back. It's a leadoff home run for the Quakers. Bottom of the 6th. Sarah Schneider goes yard to center and makes it a 5-2 ball game from Philadelphia. A solo shot from Sarah Schneider. Came into a pinch hit, her last AB, 1-0 pitch on his way here. Drive this one, deep right field, going back, and it's gone! Walk it off, the Quakers win! Deep to right field, Corey Phillips wins it for the Quakers! 7-6, your final score from Penn Park. Late game dramatics for the Quakers. 4 runs scored in the bottom of the 7th as Penn wins it. 7-6, your final score. Longo 3 strikeouts on the contest. Yesterday was really effective. A 5-inning shutout, only allowing 2 hits as Farrell will get this one to loop. And what a grab! Ashley Waco off balance, sprawls for it, makes the grab, and steals a base hit away from Willa Ferrer. Ashley Waco. What an athletic play to just find the speed of the last second and leap for it, make the grab and put one away. Same spot, Waco going for it, called off that time. Brianna Brown will make the grab and say, hey, cool it. I'm gonna make the grab that time, put 2 away. So Lauren Perrin goes down on the pop-up to right as Alex Perrin will step up. Top of the 4th, 2 quick outs on only 2 pitches. Make it 3 as it's looped over to Julius Schneider, who makes the grab to finish things up. Top of the 4th, nothing doing for Yale. The Quakers lead 9-1. Bottom of the 4th, we go from Philadelphia. More with the Ivy League on ESPN.
Aaron Gray, the senior from the Empire State, sets up 2-1 pitch. Bean, this one, line to center, coming after and making the grab. The throw to first will be in time. What a play. Brianna Brown in center field, able to make the diving grab, then throw back to first. Very unconventional double play, 8-3 double play. The Quakers get 2 down. In the top half,
at least as of right now, with that top spot. 0-2.
This one swung on, lifted to center. Schneider takes it for a ride. Deep back, gone! Do it again, Sarah Schneider! Nedley, 1-for-6 on the series. Base hit and a walk. The 0-1 from Latta. Swung on, deep back. Forget it! Emma Nedley, a 3-run shot. Extends the lead to 4. Emma Nedley with a blast in the bottom of the first. 5-1, the Quakers lead. Emma Nedley's 4th of the year for the senior. Trying to send her off with a bang. That's a good way to start off the contest. Nedley goes yard. 5-1, Penn leads. Quakers as they host the Yale Bulldogs and look to send off the class of 2022 with a victory. It's Yale and Penn, the Ivy League on ESPN. Big day for the Quakers trying to get the big win for their senior class here today, sending 6 seniors off with this Game 3 contest versus Yale and the Bulldogs, both being split yesterday, so the Quakers trying to win their first Ivy League series in quite some time. Hello and thank you for tuning in as the Quakers and the Bulldogs face off here today on this sunny Saturday afternoon from Philadelphia. Garrett Lee with you for things today. Both teams trying to round out their season with a victory.
3-1 here. Harsh awaits the deal. Bunt showed. It's dropped right in front of the plate. No one's over at first, and it's lost. That'll allow Nagoski to come in to score. Green light waved around third. Still going as Harsh as it's banged into the corner. The throw will not come to the plate in time. Clear the two runners on. It's an inside the park home run for Julia Harsh. Robo trying to get out, no damage done. 3-0 lead for Ryder. This one swung on in line, high and deep in the left field, and you can forget it. See ya! Julia Harsh, a solo homer. Take a look at our hoop team, player of the game. Pretty obvious choice. Jesse Nagoski, a career high 11 strikeouts on the day. She's been excellent, pitching 5 scoreless innings so far. The Bronx up 7-0. This one's grounded up the middle, won't be able to get it, was Yule. The green light given, but tripping at third. The throw back to third will go away towards the Ryder dugout, then will be waved along, and Ryder puts one more on the board as Ludke drives one into center, and then we see Kristen Gardner come in. It's 8-1, Bronx on top, bottom 6. Nagoski shot straight up the middle. Kuntz will walk in. Nagoski stands up at first. 2 runs come in to score. And Jesse Nagoski starts the day excellent. In the circle, 13 strikeouts. And then she's able to walk it off. Ryder takes it.
Down in Gloucester County, 1-1. Another bunt played down. Right will attack. They throw to first. Lost. And now, will there be a throw to the plate? There will not, and Burrows comes in to score. 1-2, 2 on in scoring position. Nobody down as Kuntz awaits. This one shot into right center field. It will drop. Thomas will field it off the hop. The throw back in will be the second. It's cut off, and 2 runs score as Brianna Kuntz makes it 3-0. Ryder on top.
After going 0-for-3 in game 1. High fly ball into right center field, and you can kiss it goodbye. Olivia Burrow, a 2-run homer, extends the lead to 4. Ryder up 5-1. Burrow 3-for-3 in game 2, explodes things here in the bottom of the 6th, a 2-run shot.
It's a 5-2 lead for Ryder in the Bronx. Top of 7th, a 1. Popped up into center field. Wright will get after it. Makes the grab. Ball game. Bronx win it. 5-2. Your final here from Lawrenceville.
One nothing lead for Princeton and the Tigers. So far, offense coming at a premium. 4 hits for Princeton. Only 1 for the Quakers. Good pitching from both sides. Brielle Wright really starting to get into her own. The freshman now 3 Ks on the day, 2 coming in the last inning. As Dana Anderson has that one hit for Penn, she'll take in a lead off this bottom of the fourth, trailing by one. That's right. First pitch fired on the outside, well away. It's ball one. So the wind's shifting a little bit. We mentioned how the wind being a factor, as it tends to be here in these early Ivy contests in Philadelphia, and specifically Penn Park. As next pitch, beautifully spotted on a low outside shade. It's 1-1. Well, we've seen it kind of spiral in towards home plate as it's starting to do now. We've seen it push out towards center. 1-1, Anderson awaits. Looks away, it's 2-1. Anderson has that lone hit, like we mentioned, after going 0-for-3 on Friday's contest. Was hitless in three straight coming into today, able to break that streak. 2-1, nobody on, nobody away, leadoff batter in the fourth. Anderson awaits, Wright's pitch, swung on line, straight back into the netting. 2-2. So Anderson will await the 2-2 now, as Wright looking for another punch out to set the deal. The pitch upstairs, it runs full. Started each of the last two innings with a strikeout. And in a chance to do it here, it's Princeton trying to stay near the top of the Ivy with a win here today. 6-1, looking to go 7-1. Full count, Anderson awaits. Pitch dealt, low, called for ball four. So Dana Anderson will break the trend of leadoff batters retired. She gets on by way of the walk. And we'll also see a pinch runner to check in here. As Jade Montgomery will pinch run. Montgomery will work, and we've seen Montgomery a couple times this year, mainly in this spot. Incredibly bundled up. Cannot blame her. A freshman from Buford, Georgia. We'll take it. As Sammy Fenton will try and do some damage with a leadoff base runner on. Fenton also gone on by way of the walk, her last AP. First pitch from Wright. It swung on and lifted high in the center field. Going after and making the grab was Ohlone. Now we'll put one away, a healthy hack. And again, as we mentioned, maybe if the wind was pushing the other way, that one's extra bases. But it pushes back towards the center fielder, and Ohlone gets after it, makes the grab, puts one away.
The catcher, Sarah Schneider.
And Sarah Schneider will step in, 0-for-1 on the day. One away here for the catcher and Schneider. Pitched away, popped up from Papert. Wanted to throw over to first. As Montgomery was a little bit off the bag. Schneider, top 10 in slugging, average, and RBIs in the Ivy. One up, upstairs, took a swing at it. 1-1. Maybe more just had the hit and run sign put on. Not the best take there from Schneider. 1-1, set, deliver. Swung on and missed down low. Goes to 1-2 and just kind of out of the mechanics here. Seems to be Sarah Schneider. Numbers still good, not necessarily where they were a year ago where she led the Ivy in homer. Still solid though, batting over 320. Struggling at this at bat. 1-2, bottom four, 1-0 lead for Princeton. One away and a runner on first. This one is driven up the middle. Will give Sarah Schneider her first hit of the day. Put two on for the Quakers and one away. So Sarah Schneider able to get back on track after an 0-for-2 day on Friday. Lines one straight up the middle, and the Quakers have two on and one away. And that will lead Delaney Smith. At least expected to be Delaney Smith. That might not be the case. We'll likely see a freshman and Danny Freer step in. So Smith will check out. We'll see how that kind of changes things defensively. But Freer will take in. Haven't seen a lot of Freer. Has gotten her fair share of starts. Went versus Dartmouth. Went versus Harvard. Was good in a couple of pinch hitting opportunities versus Harvard. 1-for-2 with an RBI. Versus the Crimson. 0-for-2 on Friday, though, as Smith struck out her last day at bat, so we'll see Freer check in instead. Freer batting just a tad below 200. It's probably the toughest spot we've seen Real Wright get into all day long. Had two runners on in the first, but had two outs, so quickly got out of it by way of the pop-up from Schneider. Now Schneider sits at first. Jade Montgomery, who pinch runs, is at second. The 1-0, bunt showed, it's not played. Called for a strike. Oh, 1. Freer, the East Greenville, PA native, the 0-1. Bunt showed again, it's popped up, heading foul. Luckily does, as Marsala almost made an extraordinary grab. Charging down the line, the count goes 0-2. That's something you can't let happen if you're Freer. Can't pop that one up. And a tough day to try and lay down a bunt with the wind. But you have to play it down, as Wright will likely deal down again. Well, up again. 0-2. Bunt showed, bunt pulled back as you go around. And they say yes. It's another punch out on the day for Wright. Fourth strikeout for Brielle Wright. She sits down. Freer put two down.
Left fielder Katie Reagan.
Reagan will step in now. It's Brielle Wright. Great day today. Gets Freer going around. Now two outs and two on. Reagan will try and keep the inning going. Hopefully for the Quakers would drive in that runner at second. To get on with the leadoff base runner, that's the goal, to drive that runner in. Trailing by one. And the go-ahead run sitting at first as well. Reagan 0-for-1 on the day. Right deals, 0-1. Beautiful pitch. Great pitch on the outside with the changeup. It's 0-2. Now Wright looking back-to-back K's to get out of the inning. No damage done and leaving two runners stranded. Wright, 0-2, two away, two on. Up by one. Wright kicks, fires, delivers, fastball away. It's 1-2 now. Sets, fires, delivers for the Rockland, California native we talked about. Five strikeouts in the last contest. Really starting to get going. Saw six versus Yale as well. 1-2. Do it again. Reagan awaits the deal. Pitch. This one on a line into left field. It will drop. Starks will hit it off a bounce. The throw will be cut off. The run will score for the Quakers. The throw back to second. Not in time. So Katie Reagan will drive in Jade Montgomery, and the Quakers will tie things up at one apiece. Bottom of the fourth, even up here in Philadelphia. Really difficult spot to do it in. Two outs and two strikes, but Reagan gets a liner into left field. Starks wasn't able to get after it, and the throw was cut off. Bottom of the fourth, we're tied one apiece. And Alyssa Pope will step in. Same spot, two on, two away. Right deals, this one's popped up straight up in the air, shallow center field, a trio of Tigers on it, and it's dropped! Cipollone can't make the grab, the throw will go back to the plate, but the Quakers will take the lead, it's 2-1, bottom of the fourth! And Alyssa Pope will move all the way to second, and some miscommunication in center field allows a run to come aboard, and the Quakers take the lead. Cipollone, as well as Bonnie and Jackson, were all going for the same ball in shallow center. So Cipollone called them all off and then maybe just lost it in the air. And it allows a run to come aboard, and the Quakers take a one-run lead in the fourth. A huge error made in center field. And one that, in a game like this, as close as it's been, you really can't afford, and it will lead to Coach Van Akron to come talk with the infield. It's Van Akron, we mentioned, a former Quaker, as an assistant coach here, also spent time at Lehigh as a player, was a former All-Patriot League Pitcher of the Year with the Mountain Hawks, so no stranger to the Quakers on both sides of it. Now as a longtime head coach at Princeton. Two outs on the board and two in scoring position now for Danica Larwell. First pitch is away, it's ball one. Danica Larwell, 0-for-1 on Friday's contest, 0-for-1 today with a strikeout. It's a chance to keep this successful inning going for the Quakers. 2-1 lead, Penn. Two in scoring position. Striking are the Quakers as Larwell pops one backwards. Foul. We go to 1-1. And right, we mentioned, has been very, very impressive today. That was a chance to get out and only allow the one run to go aboard. 1-1. Larwell watches one low and away. It's ball two. Can't get that spot. We go back 2-1. Two out pitch, two in scoring position. Larwell calls time. But for Wright, that's really tough in center with Cipollone, the play that was made. Because got the pitch you need, got the piece of contact that you need to get out. Just weren't able to, and now two in scoring position, two away. Larwell awaits the 2-1. Looked that away, it's 3-1. Now you're in danger of blowing the bases, and you have to think here as a coach with Van Akron. What do you do if you do give up the walk here? Three-one count, the deal. That one catches, goes full. A little bit better of a spot behind the plate. Papert's able to frame that one a little bit nicer. Albert pitcher, this right has been able to get that pitch to go on the outside pretty much all day. Full count now, two away, two in scoring position. Larwell awaits as Wright deals. Pitch 3-2, swung on, popped up. It will drop down the line. Larwell will stand up at first. A two-run base hit extends the lead for the Quakers. So Marsalo was going after it. Two runs will come aboard, and the Quakers lead 4-1. Four runs scored in the bottom of the fourth. The top of the order returns here, as all four runs coming with two outs on the board. And now Brianna Brown will step up with a runner at first, exploding in this inning of the Quakers. So Penn will take their first lead of the series as well here, game two. Turner dropping the opener, 7-0. BB will line one into the netting backwards, foul, it's 0-1. Brown, 5 RBIs on the year, sits with a runner at first. A productive fourth inning for the Quakers. 0-1, Wright trying to get out the deal. Down low, it's 1-1. And now you really have to kind of wonder on the side, as the freshman has been great today, but this is easily put her in a tough spot going forward. It's about the range she went versus Ryder as well. 1-1. Swung on, fouled. Goes to 1-2 now. Went 5 versus the Bronx. As Brown, 2 outs on the board. Runner at first in Larwell. Count goes 1-2. Desperately trying to get out now. Here's Riel Wright. Gets the sign for the dugout. Deal on 1-2. Swung on, popped up. Left field. Foul territory. And Starks comes in on it, makes the grab. And that will end the inning. Not before the Quakers put 4 runs on the board. Top of the 5th we go. 4-1 lead. Penn on top. Princeton tries to answer when we come back on ESPN+.